By the end of this video, you will understand what a short squeeze is and how to profit off one. The only thing I ask of you in return for this video is that you hit that beautiful like button, and also if you see value, subscribe for more short, sweet, and simplified videos on how to trade the stock market. So to understand a short squeeze, the first thing that you need to know is the transaction that happens when you short a stock. When you're shorting a stock, aka betting against the stock, you literally are borrowing a share from a broker and then selling it. Now, when you borrow the share, the agreement between you and the broker is that regardless of what happens to the share in terms of price, you will still repay that broker by giving them back the same amount of shares of the company that you borrowed. So if you've borrowed a stock and that share price goes up or down, you still have that money from the share that you had sold, but you now need to buy another share in order to pay back the broker. Of course, if the stock price went down, the money you made from selling that share exceeds the current cost. And if the price went up, you have to buy back the share at a higher cost, so you then lost money. So now a short squeeze is basically when a lot of people have borrowed and sold shares of a particular stock, and now that stock price is rising. That means that all of these people who had borrowed shares in hopes of the stock going down are now seeing an increasing share price. So every extra cent the stock goes up is an extra cent that these people have to pay in order to get those shares back to the broker. So as the stock price goes up, more and more of the shorts decide it's time to buy back the shares to return them to the brokers. In trading terminology, this is called covering your shares. So these people covering their positions, aka buying back shares, causes the price to increase even more because the demand has increased. But as the price increases, more and more short sellers rush to buy back shares, causing the stock price to increase even more rapidly. At the same time, the original momentum that pushed the stock up may still be running, and outside investors may be trying to buy into higher highs, which all around can lead to an insane price increase. So an example of a stock that is heavily influenced by short squeezing is Tesla. You may notice that the time it takes Tesla to break down, its share price tends to be a lot slower than the time it takes to increase. One of the reasons for this is because Tesla is one of the most shorted stocks. I don't think it is at this point, but in a lot of different points, it was the most shorted stock. So whenever we see it nearing spitting distance of highs, short sellers start piling on the stock, and that combined with the overreaction or the hype that brought up the stock in the first place, such as Elon Musk's tweets, then dies down over the upcoming weeks and months. But now Tesla is sort of a cookie cutter example because it allows for swing traders to sort of buy in at the common support levels and sell out at resistance, which is great because even the more conservative players would be able to find great entry and exit points by just simply using the RSI. But the thing is, understanding that this stock is prone to short squeezes further incentivizes us to identify the perfect entry and exit points to hold through the squeeze. So in order to find the stocks that are prone to short squeezes, we need to figure out which stocks are heavily shorted but also fit our trading criteria. Say we have a list of 10 stocks that we think might fit our trading criteria. We then go and plug them into the NASDAQ short interest website. I'll put a link to that in the description to make it easier. Also, it gives you the section below of the top searched in short interest for the day, which could give you an idea of the perception of the company. And you can add some of those to the list, but let's just plug in a bunch of random tickers. So once it's open, you get the settlement date, the short interest, average daily share volume, and days to cover. Now you'll see short interest. Now short interest is the number of shares sold short during the settlement date. Unfortunately, most exchanges only post settlement dates for a couple different periods. Most of them do one period, but this NASDAQ website does two, so you're not going to get a day-to-day short interest ratio, which is honestly fine. It doesn't give you the full picture, but it gives you a pretty good idea of what it's at. So again, short interest is the number of shares sold short during the settlement date, at this settlement date. Now, the number in itself doesn't tell you much because different companies have different numbers of shares in circulation. That's also known as shares outstanding, but there's a different amount of shares outstanding. So it doesn't matter if you have 100,000 shares short, but you only have 200,000 shares in total. Like, that's a huge deal, right? Like, I don't think that's possible, but it never happened. But still, like, it's a huge deal. So it's all about the size of the market capitalization of the company and how many shares are out there, or how many shares are outstanding. So this is where it gets interesting. So the days to cover section tells you how long it would take using the average daily volume for short sellers to cover their positions if positive news came out. So that means the higher the number, the longer it would take shorts to cover their shares if something were to happen that made the price go up. In other words, the higher the number, the higher the chance of a short squeeze if the price was to suddenly go up on news or any sort of catalyst. Okay, so this is where the dogs start barking. If the amount of days to cover is really high, that means shorts are going to be struggling to buy back shares. Now, remember, the higher the price goes, the more the short sellers lose, and thus the stock price increases more and more as the short sellers struggle to recover their shares. So more and more short sellers will rush to cover their positions as the price action trends up, but the very action of this creates an even higher share price, which generally increases the volume since the price increase has drove current shareholders into the market to sell. And this process is called the short squeeze. So what level is a stock that has a high short interest? So you're going to want to find stocks that have a high number of days to cover. A lot of traders use 7 or 8 as the benchmark, but I'll generally look for over 10. I think I just made a lot of people who have shorted stocks kind of raise their eyes. I try to make sure that things are as concrete as possible just because of the fact that a lot of these stocks, a lot of times, even if there are a very large amount of shorts, not going to have enough impact on the share price. So it's better to be a little bit careful with this. So a lot of traders use 7 or 8 as a benchmark, but I'll generally look for over 10. Now, then what I'll do is add these to my watch list, and if I see signs of a reversal, such as the ones we've talked about in my two steps of a stock reversal video, then I'll proceed accordingly. Another thing is when I'm evaluating for positions to take, a lot of times what I'll do is look to see, you know, how are the shorts acting in terms of the stock price. I like to look from month to month in terms of, you know, every 15-day period as well, just because you can kind of see like what the sentiment in terms of the investors are, and you can kind of base some longer swing positions off that as well in terms of not even looking for a short squeeze. So anyways, the strategy that I employ with this is I'll add these to my watch list, and if I see signs of a reversal, such as the ones we've talked about in my two steps of a stock reversal video, I never take a position specifically because it's being massively shorted. That's not a very good strategy. You have to see signs of an uptrend or it doesn't make sense. That means you're just buying into the shorts and the stock price keeps going down and you're just going to lose money. You need to have some sort of reason to believe it's going to go up. So if you couldn't tell, I generally treat short squeezes the same way that I treat a lot of different stocks. It's just that the amount of return is a little bit sweeter if I do pull it off. And the reason is because the fact that it's being massively shorted just makes it a much better setup if I do see those signs of a reversal. Anyways, if you have any questions, comment below or join our free ZipTrader Circle Facebook group. I post nightly watch lists and a bunch of little newsletters here and there that could be kind of entertaining and helpful. But anyways, I hope that you guys had some value in this video, and I'll see you in the next one.